ramblings of a Disciplined Podcast for Tuesday, March 22nd, 2016. As of this recording, Sierra is still missing. So it is a sunny, sunny day here. It was like 30-something, but right now it feels like it's about 75, 80 in my car as I'm sitting outside a little bit, so hoping it kind of cools down a bit. Yeah, because it's kind of on the warm side. That's good. I mean, I enjoy the warmth. So right now, this is feeling like, my car is feeling like, you know, like when you get into a hot bath and you go, or better, you know, pull the sweater out of the dryer. It's kind of this feeling like right now. I like it. Today was barbecue day. I went to Dickie's, as you can tell by my big yellow cup. Got me a brisket sandwich. It was good stuff. I've been jonesing for barbecue. I really have. So I've been jonesing for brisket. So yeah, brisket. Yeah. You know, it was a pie chart, and it was labeled something along the lines of introverts' desire to talk on the phone, and in the legend area it had a little blue dot, and the blue dot represented don't want to talk to people at all on the phone. And the pie chart was just a blue circle. There was no other response. If you're an introvert, you didn't want to talk to people on the phone. And you know, that was totally me. And still can be me. Yeah, I have gotten past that quite a bit. And that was because I was forced to for work. I never really liked talking to people on the phone. It would be the type of thing that I would put off and not do it. And then I got a job as a consultant. And while I'm still an introvert, it taught me a lot about, I guess, being a better functioning introvert, maybe. I've learned how to kind of wear my extrovert hat at times. And you can do that as an introvert, but the thing is that, after you do that, then you need to go be an introvert for a while and kind of recharge. You can't be doing the extrovert thing all the time. And, and so part of that was, getting used to talking to people on the phone and having to make calls. Now, generally speaking, I wasn't making, I wasn't like cold calling. I wasn't doing any of that kind of stuff. Although I did try to do a little bit of that when I was thinking of trying to get some freelance writing going, and I hated it. The passion. But even just, hey, I need you to call this customer because they need help with X or Y, and just having to get on the phone with them, and I don't want to talk to people on the phone. But I had to do it because I had to perform my duties. And it's also the same thing, when you're a consultant. If you go to a customer's location, you're going to their location, you are representing the company, and you're saying to them, so you gotta be there, you have to be personable, you have to introduce yourself. In some ways it's a little bit like being in a job interview. And while I still hate that, although I haven't been on one in quite a while, it's the same kind of thing, is that you're walking into a situation where you don't know people. Don't necessarily know the situation. In most cases, you've traveled to be there, and you know you're there to get something specific done. And you know you can't. I won't say you can't, but you know that's something where you can't really be a 100% introvert there, because you have to interact with your customer. You have to find out what it is that they want, what is it looking to get done. The thing about being a consultant is you may come in to do thing A, but while you're there, they might ask you to do thing B, and also give them some ideas about how could we handle thing C or D. So, you know, I did learn how to be able to do that and handle that, and then, you know, I would have, and so I've learned to put on my consulting hat for that. I used to go to some of these user conferences, and I would go there, and I would hang out. This particular one I went to, there was a guy I worked with who was a friend of mine, and I would hang out a lot with him, and we'd be interacting with vendors, and so I basically had to have my extrovert hat on, you know, for the majority of the week, and then you know, by the end of the week, I was like dead. I was just like, I need a nap, I need to relax, I need to do something that's not talking to people. So yeah, I get the whole introvert thing, because I are one, as the saying goes. And I totally get the phone thing. And it just, you know, kind of got me thinking. I saw that pie chart, if that's what we're calling it, and that totally got me thinking about how I used to very much be like that. And I'm less so now. But I can still, you know, if there's like a particular phone call that I got to make that I'm just like not looking forward to it, you know, I will become the master procrastinator and just procrastinate on that. That's what I felt like talking about today. I will be back tomorrow, being Wednesday, and I'll be talking to you then. So, be seeing you.